So here's what I thought was interesting, because I was really, I did try to do a little research on this segment here. So I was looking through them, and there wasn't that much difference once you get outside, really, the Chiefs and the Rams, because I think they are separate. They are both have really good offenses. The Chiefs are bad defensively, but they actually played better against the Jaguars. But that's Blake Bortles. So it's like, all right, you should play better
against
them.
Throwing balls off helmets.
But once you start getting past them, the Patriots have the pedigree, right? But they've looked vulnerable this year. So even the Patriots, you could say they looked susceptible to getting beat this year.
Sure.
You could make a strong case once you get past the first two or three. Like, I could tell you, I could say, hey, the Bengals, they're 4-1. They've actually been playing great behind Andy Dalton. Like, I can make a case for them to be over the Vikings.
Yeah.
Same with the Panthers. Cam Newton is thriving with this new offensive system in Norv Turner, and Christian McCaffrey's having an all-pro type season. I can make a case for them to be higher. The Bears, who nobody thought would be in this position, are playing great. They had a bye week this past week, but Mitch Trubisky's looking good, and that defense looks like all of a sudden they could be, you know, pulling off the 85 Bears. Like, they look like they could be that dominant. I think that's the thing that kind of jumps out to me, is there are these two teams at the top, and then there's a whole bunch of teams that you can make a really strong case for. And even outside of this top 10, which is exactly why I think the NFL is so entertaining, because there's so much parity week to week. You never know who's going to win. And your team, they can, in baseball, when the baseball season unfolded, within like the first month of the season, it was like, oh, these teams are going to be bad. They have no chance at the playoffs.
Right.
You go all the way down the list, and it, aside from your bottom, your bell bottoms, a lot of teams that are still in there, they're 2-2 or 2-3, like around there. Even 1-4 teams still feel like they have a chance to make the playoffs, and though they probably don't.
Right.
There's a lot of parity.
Well, the parity combined with like the league's effort to increase scoring, you know, which they've been undertaking the last couple of years, I think has. It's been a really entertaining first, what would you call it, quarter of a season or first, and I would tend to agree with you that the Rams and the Chiefs seem to be the cream of the crop.